Good afternoon, friends, and welcome back to the finals hall here at the Gabala Shooting Club for another action-packed event, 10-meter air rifle men. I'm Hillary Russell, and I'm delighted to have USA's assistant rifle coach and U.S. Army's head rifle coach, Jason Parker, here with me today. Welcome, Jason, and thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Do you want to go over to over what we're going to be seeing today during this final?
During today's final, we're going to have eight of the final competitors from today's qualification round shooting the final. The final will consist of two series of three shots. Then they will move into single shots. The series of shots are fired in 150 seconds, 2.5 minutes. In the single shots, you'll have 50 seconds to complete one final shot. After eight final shots total, they will have an elimination for an athlete, and then every other shot will have an athlete eliminated as well.
Okay, so as we were talking before, Jason was kind enough to join me for the women's event that just finished up here. The first two series shots are really pretty important to shoot really well, because once you finish off these first two series and you get into the single shots, and if you haven't shot well in the first two series, it's really kind of difficult to make that up.
They are. With the time restriction you have at 2.5 minutes, those first two series really set the tone for the competition. You can really build some confidence and some momentum coming out of those shots. If you shoot them really well, it doesn't really decide who the medalist will be. But if you shoot them poorly, you can almost guarantee an early elimination.
And we have got talent, and more talent out there today. It's really an unbelievable group of finalists today. Of course, that's to be expected. We are here at the World Cup Final, where only the elite are invited to participate in this last event of the 2014 ISSF season. And so I think we're going to see pretty high scores, and we're going to keep an eye on two young men that we have not really seen a whole lot of, but have just burned up the scoreboards, burned up the podium this year. And we'll have a chance to introduce them to you in just a couple minutes.
This is one of my favorite events. As I go around, talk to different people about the sport, they always ask what makes the champion, or what's the difference between the champions and somebody who's not quite there. Is it technique? What is it that's about it? But really, they're shooters that shoot good well in practice but not competitions, or somebody who shoots a good qualification round but not a final. But all of these shooters up here have demonstrated already that they are the best in the world. They have the mental toughness to go into a competition and win a final, because all of these people have won a medal during a World Cup or the World Championships this year. So these are the toughest competitors out there, and we have all eight of them lined up on the firing line right now.
So in just a couple seconds, we'll have a chance to meet these finalists today. I think we've got a range basically of from 18 years old up to 38. And in fact, on firing point A, here is our 18-year-old representing the People's Republic of China. We have Yang Horan.
Now, 18 years old, very young, but already a very accomplished shooter. This year, winning the World Championship gold medal in Zagreb and also the Munich World Cup.
He is really an amazing guy. Also, just to give you a little bit more idea of who this young man is, he's also the Youth Olympic Games gold medalist this year. He's unstoppable, a really, really kind and nice guy, and he's someone we're going to have to keep our eye on in the future, because he has really cleaned up shop this year.
Absolutely. Somebody that young and that talented, they're going to have a good long career.
On firing point B, representing Hungary, we've got Peter City.
Peter Seedy this year qualified at the Maribor World Cup, where he won a silver medal there. But he's 4 years ago, he is also the World Championship silver medalist in this event.
On firing point C, representing the Russian Federation, we've got Sergei Kruglov.
Kruglov is going to be very interesting to watch on this one. He qualified with the World Cup in Munich this year. He finished fourth place in Granada this year, so 1 point out of the firing line, or out of the medals, he's going to be wanting some redemption.
On firing point D, representing Israel, we have Sergei Richter.
Sergei Richter, he qualified this year with the World Cup bronze medal, and another very talented shooter who's been around for a while.
on firing point E, representing the People's Republic of China. It's no surprise not to see Xu Qinan enter into the World Cup final today.
Now, he's been around for a long time, an Olympic gold medalist in Athens, silver medal in Beijing, qualified this year in Maribor with the gold medal, so he's a tough competitor, one to watch.
On firing point F, representing Italy, we've got Niccolò Campriani.
Niccolò, this year he qualified at the Munich World Cup, but the Olympic Games, he's a silver medalist from London and also a world champion from Munich 2010.
And there's his girlfriend, Petra Zubusing. On firing point G, representing the Belarus, we have Vitaly Bubnovich.
Yeah, he was a pleasant surprise this year at the World Championships, earning the bronze medal to get qualified for this event.
And the other one who's really hot on this season, on firing point H, representing the Russian Federation, is Nazar Louginets.
Absolutely, this year a fantastic year. A silver medal at the World Championships in Granada, a gold medal in Beijing at this year, and Fort Benning also this year. So quite a good year for this young man.
And not only does he participate in this event, but also in the 50-meter rifle three positions men, where he also medaled twice this year. So it's going to be a tough one, Jason, to figure out who's going to end up on the podium today with this talent out here. We've seen all of them before, and they all have proven, of course, this year to make it into this elite competition.
Absolutely. This is a very star-studded final right here. Very accomplished shooters. And again, what I was saying before, different levels of athletes that they come in, and some of them come in and they struggle in the finals, but all of these athletes here are mentally tough, they're confident, and we'll see who ends up on top after this final.
Okay, we're going to be going into the first series of three shots. Again, it's 150 seconds. You know, it's no surprise really to see two of the gentlemen that are in today's final representing the People's Republic of China, and also two representing the Russian Federation. Two very strong, strong teams. What do you suppose is going through these guys' minds right now, Jason?
Right now they are getting their focus narrowed down to exactly what they have to do to perform a perfect shot. The nerves are pumping, the heart's racing, and right now every one of them knows that there's a certain step in their process that they take that will produce a good shot, and that's what they're concentrating on right now. Controlling the heartbeat and just performing a perfect shot.
So here he is, the youngest one in today's final, Yang Horan. See him just let out a little breath of air there and focus right in.
So the Chinese shooters, they have absolutely perfect technique. Like I was saying, they were going through certain steps so that they could produce a good shot. Harang Yang here, he's absolutely one of the best and one of the hottest young shooters right now on the firing line.
Starting off with a 10.0. City starting off with a 9.9. You know, once again, just to reiterate, after the qualifications, their qualification scores do not carry over into the final. And so after this first series of shots, it really is anybody's game to find out who's going to end up in first place. Of course, it's really, really early into the final, and things can change around. All you need is a couple of solid 10.9s, and that'll get you right up the scoreboard.
It is. These first series of shots, they're probably one of the most difficult. It's either getting started in the competition for the first couple shots, or when you're there at the one of the final people standing up there going for the medals or the gold medal. Those are the toughest shots in the competition. So you see a lot of people right now struggling with just controlling their body and unable to hold the rifle well enough to produce a good score.
It's a nice 10.8 for Louginets. We're seeing these first two shots. We were seeing, just want to talk just for a second about Bubnovich. He started off in the 10 ring, and then the second shot was an 8.9, and then it's a 9.1. But let's see if Louginets can stay in the 10 ring and shoot as strong as he just came off.
really one of the things that the athletes need to be concerned about here is just performing a good shot. A lot of times they get up there in a situation like this and they try to make every shot absolutely perfect, which puts more pressure on themselves. But if you go up there, do like you do in practice in the qualification round, produce a good quality shot, usually the results are good.
All right, so let's just take a look here at the standings. We have got Shu in first place, owned by a mere 1/10 of a point advantage over Louginets. Richter in third place, 4/10 of a point behind. We've got City holding on to fourth place, 1/10 of a point. It's a really, really tight game right now. Bubnovich is holding on to eighth place. He's almost a point behind Kruglov. We still have one more series to go and then two shots to find out who's going to be finishing off in eighth place.
Yeah, we have five more shots until that eighth place is decided, and only a little over a point in between the top seven or eight shooters. And so still it's anybody's game to come back in here after these next three shots.
You know, Shu Kingnan, he is a father of twin baby girls. And I'll tell you, they are very, very cute girls. And he was talking about them in Granada. But not only that, but we saw them in Beijing during the World Cup. And they wanted the stuffed animals that were being given away. And in fact, they took them from their dad. And they also took them from Cambriani, who was the silver medalist.
You know, the kids can be a dad's greatest supporter, but also they can be their toughest critic. I know some of the times I've had my kids travel to competitions, and you come out the front line, and if you didn't do so well or whatever, their first question is, why didn't you win?
Oh, dear.
So it's pretty nerve-wracking. You don't want to let them down, you know.
All right, we've got Louginets starting off with a 10.6. He's 25 years old. A 10.4. Richter with a 9.6.
You could see shots like that. You know, obviously he wasn't happy. He doesn't, by his actions, it looked like he didn't understand what happened to it. You know, things like that can really mess with the confidence of a shooter when you get up there. But there's still enough time that he can recover from it. But, you know, certainly it's difficult when you have shots that you can't explain.
And that's when you just have to mentally put it behind you. Just you can't think about it. You have to keep on moving on, which to me just seems so much easier said than done.
It is. You know, that's one of the mental aspects of this. You know, in shooting, there's not a lot of movement or running around, so it's a big battle with your mind. So you have a shot like that, you just have to leave it behind you and focus on your next shot as quickly as possible.
So we've got Louginets, who has now overtaken Shu by 4/10 of a point. Yang in third place, 1 point behind him. And Campriani in fourth place, only 1/10 of a point behind him. Everything is very, very tight right now. We've got a two-way tie for sixth place between Richter and City. And Bubnovich is holding on to eighth place by 1.4 of a point. It's really very different right now from what the women's event that we just saw earlier, where there is a whole lot more differences in the points after the second series.
Yes, at this point, you have a 1.4 deficit for Bubnovich to move into sixth place, which with only two shots remaining is very difficult to overcome.
Year-old Bubnovich.
Neither one of his first two series were very good. You know, and he's got two shots left to try to make to help himself out.
Kruglov for the 10.1. Let's take a look here. We've got Louginets still holding on to first place by 4/10 of a point after shooting a 10.1. Also Shu shooting that 10.1. Yang with a lovely 10.7 is in third place. He's only 4/10 of a point behind. Unfortunately for Bubnovich with that 10.2, he's now a point and a half behind. One shot to go to find out who's going to be finishing off in eighth place, and it looks like it's going to be Bubnovich unless something insane happens.
Yeah, it looks like Bobanovich is going to be the next one out. But after that, it tightens up, and it'll be a good race to see who ends up in the seventh and sixth positions. But what's most interesting on this one here is Louginets. He qualified for the final at eighth place today, but of course we go back to zero. But a fresh start, very talented. But this is, you know, where the mental toughness comes out, and he goes straight to the top.
He certainly is a very, very strong final shooter, without a doubt. City a 9.9. Bodnovich with a 9.9. It's not going to be enough to stay in the game. And so finishing off in eighth place, representing Belarus, we have Vitaly Bobnovich. Louginets, a little bit more of a lead now. He's now got a half a point advantage over Xu. Yang in third place, only 3/10 of a point behind. And like you were saying before, for sixth and seventh place, it's going to be a tough fight now between City and Richter, and also Kruglov. Campriani, I mean, really, it's going to be very tight for these next few shots.
After that elimination, it tightened up a whole lot. So it'll be interesting to see who's the next one. But again, you can see Chinese team is doing really well, sitting in second and third place right now. But also, you know, Russia with the first and the fifth place. You know, teams that train together really push each other to higher levels, and I think you're seeing that especially with those two countries right now.
Seeing some nice high scores right now, 10.8 for Louginets. Xu with a 10.6. Louginets is just making his lead. He's taken a couple steps forward, the 7/10 point lead advantage over Xu. Yang still in third place, 1.1/10 of a point now behind Xu. It is Kruglov who is in the hot seat now in seventh place, but only 1/10 of a point behind City. It's going to be a really tight fight right now, Jason, to find out who's going to be finishing up in seventh place. I don't think I'd bet against any of them right now.
No, absolutely not. It's very close between fourth and seventh place, and actually third and seventh place. But, you know, when they start eliminating athletes, you know, that's one of the things that when they're up to shooting, you cannot think about if you're going to be sitting down. You have to be 100% concentrated on the next shot ahead. You start worrying about if you're going to get cut or where you're going to finish in the competition, that's where it starts affecting your performance. So these eliminations are very stressful for the athlete.
City finish off with a 10.1. Kruglov, nice 10.6. And in fact, with that 10.1, we are going to have, representing Hungary, Peter City, finishing off in seventh place.
You can see this with this sport that requires such precision that Peter City, even though he fired a good shot, it was still a 10. It just wasn't good enough to continue on into the final.
Kruglov has stayed in the game. He's only 1/10 of a point now behind Yang and Campriani, who are now tied up in fourth place. Louginets, unbelievable. He has just jumped up that scoreboard. He's 1.5 points ahead of Xu. Richter now is in third place, 6/10 of a point behind.
You know, in reality, there's only 1 point separating second place from sixth place right now. So there's a lot of stuff that can happen in these next two shots. You know, maybe Xu, he won't be eliminated because he's on top of the pack, but certainly Kruglov or Yang, they can move up into the final. They won't be the next ones eliminated. But overall, Louginets is separating himself from the rest of the field with a 1.5 point lead.
Like I was saying before, you know, the guy is unstoppable, it seems like, this year. You can't seem to hold him down.
It is. You put him in this type of situation, and his confidence and personality just thrive in this situation. He's doing really well.
10.4 for Xu. Kruglov, a 10.3. That was a great shot for Yang of China. All right, we still have Louginets, 1.5 points ahead of Xu after both of them shooting a 10.4. We have got Campriani in third place, tied up with Yang. They are 6/10 of a point behind. It's a tight fight now. One shot to go, only 3/10 of a point separating Kruglov from Richter.
Only 3/10 of a point from Kruglov to Richter, but overall there's only 5/10 of a point between Campriani, Yang, Richter, and Kruglov. Just one bad shot right here can result in elimination, and you'll be out.
Okay, again, back on to Kruglov. It was back in 2012 that he won the bronze medal during the World Cup final.
Yeah, two years ago, and I'm sure that memory is still with him here during this one, and he wants to repeat that and get a silver or gold out of it, because you know this is one of the most prestigious events of the year.
All right, so finishing off in sixth place, representing the Russian Federation, we've got Sergei Kruglov. We now have a tie for fourth place between Richter and Yang. Louginets has just, you know, he keeps on getting a little bit ahead of the others. He's 1.6 tenths of a point now above Xu. Campriani in third place, 9/10 of a point behind. And like I said, Richter and Yang are tied up now for fourth place. So it's really is going to be down to his last two shots to find out who's going to finish up in fifth place.
Absolutely. All the shooters on the line, they have, whether they looked at the scoreboard or not, they have an internal awareness about where they're standing. And they know they're getting close to the medals. They know that the competition is close. So, you know, they got four more shots till they decide who's going to be the bronze or into the medal rounds. You know, so, you know, the tension is starting to build with the athletes right now.
.4 for Louginets, 10.1 for Xu. We have Richter, who had a very unfortunate 8.4, 10.7 for Campriani. Louginets still holding on to first place, and he's almost 2 points ahead of Xu. Richter, with that unfortunate 8.4, is now 2.4 tenths of a point and in fifth place. Yang is in fourth place, only 1/10 of a point behind Campriani.
Yeah, an 8.4 really is a poor shot. So you can really see the pressure coming out of that. Obviously, the standings and the medals looming very close came into play on that shot for Sergei Richter.
Let's focus in now on China's golden boy coming off of a 10.8. And this is what we like to see, and we've seen it in the past. Yang, who might not be first, he has a tendency of moving up the scoreboard towards the end of the final and overtaking his competitors.
Yeah, sitting 1/10 of a point out of a bronze medal is definitely not a bad place to be, because he's got a ways to go.
But at 9.8, it's not going to help the situation here. Although finishing off now in fifth place, representing Israel, we've got Sergei Richter. That's really an unfortunate way to finish off with the shooting in the eight ring. Louginets, 2.1 tenths of a point. It just seems like he gathers just a little bit more, a little extra point here and there, and he's moving up scoreboard higher and higher, 2.1 tenths of a point ahead of Xu. Campriani in third place. He's only 1/10 of a point behind Xu. Yang is 7/10 of a point behind Campriani. These last two shots are the tough ones, as we were talking before, Jason. This is going to determine who's going to be going and moving on to the podium and who's going to be going home in fourth place. And we've got Yang with 7/10 of a point disadvantage. Do you think he could do it in two shots?
2 points is definitely, you can come back from that in two shots, but against this field of shooters, it's very difficult. But again, going into these last two shots before you decide if you have a medal or not, it's a very tough spot. You know, this is one of the tougher spots during the final. Then obviously, when you're the last two shooting it out for the gold medal, that's a very difficult position as well.
And in fact, Yang is still in fourth place, 6/10 of a point behind. Campriani has now jumped up the scoreboard. He's overtaken Xu. He is now above Shu by 4/10 of a point. Louginets still in the lead, 2.1/10 of a point.
Yeah, Louginets, he's in a place all to his own right now. He's in a very comfortable spot. He's got a very good lead, and he knows that he doesn't need the absolute perfect shots to win this one now. So he's going to be a little bit more relaxed and be able to pull through this. But the other three, very bunched up, very close, going for
the
A medal right now.
Exactly. We have Campriani with a 10.6. Let's take a look at these two teammates, Xu and Yang. 10.5 for Yang. Then a 10.2 for Xu. Which means finishing off in fourth place, representing the People's Republic of China, we have got Yang Horan. Again, very young guy, somebody to keep our eye on in the future.
He might be disappointed in his fourth place finish, but he has had a fantastic year. And as being a young athlete, I'm sure he'll be back here in the World Cup final for more opportunities to win his gold medal in this event as well.
Okay, we're onto the podium now. We've got two shots to go to find out who's going to be going home with the bronze. We've got Xu holding on to third place by 8/10 of a point. Louginets, as you were saying before, Jason, is kind of in a place all of his own. He's almost 2 points ahead of Campriani.
Yeah, 8/10 of a point between Xu and Campriani. That can be overcome, but 1.9 from second place to first place, that's a very good lead. Louginets is having a very good final right now.
Nice, Campriani with a 10.7. But Louginets is the guy to talk about right now with a perfect 10.9 and 9.8 for Xu. Lovely shooting by Louginets, a 10.9 that just helps his situation a little bit more if that is even possible.
Absolutely, that a perfect 10.9. They happen, but they're very rare, and it's hard to do that. But in this situation, wow, just really coming through, and he's not gonna take his foot off the gas pedal, so to speak, and just coast into the gold medal. He's gonna do it in style with that 10.9.
Louginets coming off that 10.9.
Now Nico's last shot of a 10.7. The Jews 9.8 made a difference of 1.7, which is going to be very difficult to overcome in one shot.
But I want to also take a good look at Campriani, because it seems like it's his last shot that this year seems to be bothering him a bit. He's not shooting as strong as he wants to, but a 10.0, that's the way to do it. 10.3 for Louginets. And our bronze medalist today, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Xu Qinan. And we've got Campriani, who's going to be fighting it out for the gold, but he's got 2.4/10 of a point between himself and Louginets. I don't see Louginets for any reason to be stepping down from where he's at right now.
No, absolutely not. 2.4 points is a lot in anybody's book, but I guess the thing to watch right now is will he continue it for the last two shots? He knows he has a big lead, and just continue to put that forth, that effort in the last two and do really well in the final.
So there he is, our 2012 Olympic Games silver medalist, Nico Campriani, going for the silver, trying for the gold. Let's see what happens. 10.0. And also the same for Louginets. Nothing has changed between the two of them. 2.4/10 of a point separating Louginets from Campriani, and one shot to go for the gold. And I have to say that Louginets has bagged it.
Yes, it would appear so. Seen a lot of crazy things happen, but in this situation with that young man up there who's had such a fantastic year, I'd expect him to shoot another good shot, and just a mere formality of going through the process of getting it finished.
Again, a young guy we should keep our eye on in the future, Nazar Louginets, last shot to go. He's going for the gold. Yeah, 10.7, that'll do it for Nazar Louginets from the Russian Federation. Nicolo Pampriani finishing off with a 9.9. And there he is, our gold medalist representing the Russian Federation, Nazar Louginets. Fantastic shooting. Like I said, again, Jason, someone we have to keep our eye on. And our silver medalist today, representing Italy, Nicolo Campriani. Fantastic shooting also from Campriani. He moved up the scoreboard. And there are our finalists today. We've got Shu Kinan with the bronze, Nicolo Campriani with the silver, and Nazar Louginets with the gold. This was a very exciting final to watch today, I have to say, and it was really nice to have you here, Jason.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure to come here, and congratulations to Nazar Louginets, because absolutely dominant performance in that final.
We just ask everyone to stay tuned in. 2 o'clock, we're going to be moving in on over to the pistol events, starting off with 25-meter pistol women. And then we'll be going up to the shotgun range later on this afternoon for the trap women event. Jason, thanks again for joining us, and take good care.
Thank you. Thank you for having me again. The next final will be the...